music. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, everyone. This is Wednesday night Bible study. We're starting a little early tonight because last Wednesday I did a part one of this Bible study lesson with Turks Caicos on Zoom, and we were going to do part two tonight, but something has changed, so we've already got this set for 7:15, so we're going to go back and do part one for those that are viewing tonight, and then next Wednesday when we get back on Zoom with Turks Caicos, we'll do part two and we'll do it all together. So tonight we're going to be teaching part one of I Saw One. Everybody say one. I saw one sitting on the throne. In Revelation chapter 4, verse 2, we see here that John is seeing a vision, and he sees this vision that God has showed him, and he said, immediately I was in the Spirit, and behold, a throne was set in heaven, and one sat upon the throne. Heavenly Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we pray tonight, Lord, for those that are watching, those that are listening, those that are here live, Lord, those, Lord, that in the future that may watch this Bible study, this lesson, Lord, we pray that revelation will come to them, their eyes and ears and heart will be open, Lord, to receive truth. Lord, we pray tonight that you would bless those that will partake tonight. In Jesus' name, we pray, amen. Amen. So in Revelation chapter 4, 2, he saw one in heaven sitting on the throne. And the only way that we'll ever see God is through the manifestation of the flesh of God, which is Christ Jesus, the anointed vessel, Jehovah, which became our salvation. God is a spirit, and God came and wrapped himself in the flesh and dwelt among us. And so the only way we'll ever see God is that one that's sitting on the throne, and that is Christ Jesus. In Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 4, we're going to see here in the Old Testament, the reason the Israelites or the Jews or the Hebrews crucified Jesus was because Jesus was saying, I am He, I am the One, I am the Savior, I am the First, I'm the Last, I'm the Alpha, the Omega, the Beginning, the Ending, I am the Rock, I am everything that in the Old Testament Jehovah God had said that He was, and that there was no other. That there was no other God, there was no God before him or going to be after him, that he was the only Savior of the world. And so when he comes on the scene and he's saying all these things, the Jews understood what he was saying, and so they crucified him because of what he was saying, because they knew the law. They knew the Old Testament law. In this scripture it says, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. And so they knew this. They have been taught this all their life. This was something they were taught every day, in the morning, in the evening, in between morning and evening, when they were walking, when they were sitting, when they were around the house, everywhere they went, they were always reminded that there is only one God. And so without revelation that Jesus was God, they crucified him. They mocked him. They made fun of him. They said he was a false prophet. Now look, we're going to see in verse 5 it says, And thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all your heart or thine heart and with all thy soul and with all thy might. And these words which I command thee this day shall be in thine heart, and thou shalt teach them diligently unto thy children. So all their life they were taught every day that there is only one God. And so, therefore, that's why when Jesus was saying he was God, they had an issue. Without revelation that he was, they thought he was a false prophet. In Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 35, we see here he also reminds us, Unto thee it was shewed, or shown, that thou mightest know that the Lord, he is God, and there is none else beside him. So God tells us from the beginning of the Old Testament that there is no other God. There is only one God. He is God. And so again, he's laying a foundation. The first commandment, have no other God. Why? Because there is no other God. In verse 39, it says, See now that I, even I, am he, and there is no little g God but me. or with me, because there is no other God but me. And then verse 39, we see here that, know therefore this day, and consider it in thine heart, that the Lord, he is God in heaven above, and he is heaven beneath, and there is none else, no other God. James chapter 2, verse 19. Now, this is New Testament. This is the New Testament where the apostle comes. He says, thou believest that there is one God? Thou doest well. The devils also believe that there's only one God, and they tremble. They actually said to Jesus, why have you come before your time? We know who thou art. You are the Holy One. Not the Holy Trinity, the Holy One. Now, back in July 26, 1992, when I received the baptism of the Holy Ghost, got baptized in Jesus' name, not understanding why I was baptized in Jesus' name, other than they told me to get baptized in Jesus' name. After showing me the scriptures, I believed what they were showing me, and I obeyed the scriptures, and I got baptized in Jesus' name. But the next day, or that night, or the next day, I can't remember which, I was studying the Bible, praying, speaking in about seven different languages. I don't know what I was saying. I just know the sound of these different languages because I had been around the world. I have been to different places and heard different dialects and dialogues and different languages. And so I knew what they could have been if there was, you know, I don't know if, so, you know, the Asian, I don't know if it was Chinese or Japanese or Korean or whatever, but I knew the sound. And so I'm sitting there and I'm praying, and I'm just praying in the Spirit, and a cloud comes in, a Shekinah glory comes in. I'm so drunk in the Holy Ghost, I can't stand up, and I begin to open up the scriptures, and the first revelation that God gave me was the oneness of God. Now, before I went to church, I always believed in God, but I didn't have a relationship with God. I didn't go to church. I've been to church a few times for special occasions, but thought they were all the same. Didn't know that people were teaching that there's a Trinity or three gods. I thought there was only one God. Before I even saw the scriptures, I believed there's only one God. And so this didn't come as a shock to me, but it was something that became revelation to me. I understood what the scriptures were saying. It was like the words were jumping off the pages of the Bible, and the pages were coming out of the Bible, and it was so real. And I knew that this was truth, that there is only one God, and Jesus is God. And so I would turn to these scriptures, and they would just jump out at me. John, in the New Testament, chapter 8, verse 54 through 59, Jesus is talking to a group of Jews and Pharisees, and Jesus answered, if I honor myself, my honor is nothing. It is my Father that honoreth me, of whom you say that he is your God, talking to the Israelites who believe in one God. And so they're surrounding him, and they're questioning him, and he knows that they believe in one God, and he says that you say that this God is your God, yet you have not known him. But I know him, and if I should say I know him not, I shall be a liar like unto you. So he's calling them a liar because they don't really know God. Because if they knew God, they would know that he is God. And so he's pointing this out, but I know him and I keep his sayings. And here's the key scriptures, these next few scriptures. In verse 56, your father Abraham, 2,000 years before Jesus, your father Abraham rejoiced to see my day, and he saw it, and he was glad. Then said the Jews unto him, they knew what he was saying, thou art not yet 50 years old, and have you seen Abraham? You're only like 30-some years old, 32, 33 years old, and you're not even 50 yet. How have you seen Abraham? That was like 2,000 years ago. Nobody lives 2,000 years. And so Jesus said to them, verily, verily, I say unto you, before Abraham was I am. Hallelujah. Before Abraham, because he was in the beginning, and nothing was made that was not made by him. And so in verse 59, we see that they get the revelation what he's saying. They don't believe that it's true because then they took up stones to cast at him, but Jesus hid himself. And here's another one of my favorite scriptures that really just jumped out at me that night or that morning, whatever it was, John chapter 8, 23 and 24. And he said unto them, ye are from beneath. I am from above. Ye are of this world. I am not of this world. And I like this one. I said therefore unto you that you shall die in your sins if you believe not that I am he. Ye shall die in your sins. So I'm not the judge. God is the judge. But he said, if you don't believe that he is God, if you don't believe that he is the I am, that he is our salvation, that he is our Lord and Savior, then you're going to die in your sins. And I believe that to mean that if you don't believe that Jesus is Lord, and I want to be careful on this, but this is what the Bible says. The Bible tells us to be baptized in Jesus' name. Why? Because Jesus is the Father. Jesus is the Son. Jesus is the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Because he said to go baptize in his name. He said, I come in my Father's name. I'm sending the Holy Ghost in my name. And so the power is in the name. And if you don't believe that Jesus is Lord and you repeat the command instead of obey the command, then I'm a little concerned that that's not the proper way to do it and that you might not make it. I'm not the judge, but according to the scripture, I would prefer to do it the way the scripture says to do it. Isaiah 43 and verse 10 through 12. Ye are my witnesses, saith the Lord, and my servant, whom I have chosen, that you may know and believe me and understand that I am he. Before me there was no God formed. Excuse me. Neither shall there be after me. I, even I, am the Lord. And beside me, there is no Savior. I have declared, I have saved, I have shown. When there was no strange little g God among you, therefore you are my witnesses, saith the Lord, that I am God. Isaiah 44, verse 6, only one God. Thus saith the Lord, the King of Israel and his Redeemer, the Lord of hosts, I am the first, I am the last, and besides me, there is no God. There is no other God. He is the first, he is the last, he's the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning, the ending, the Savior of the world. He's the Creator. He is the great I am, the Almighty God. Somebody say amen. In Revelation chapter 1, verse 8, in the end of the Bible, we see Jesus coming and saying everything that Jehovah, God of the Old Testament, said. So if you don't have revelation that he is God wrapped in the flesh, then you think he's a false prophet because the Old Testament said there's only one God. And he was the first and he was the last and he was the only God. There's not any beside him. And God's not going to change his mind. The Bible says that his word shall not change. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the ending, saith the Lord, Jesus, which is and which was and which is to come, the Almighty. So he's claiming to be the God of the Old Testament, the Almighty, the first and the last. That's exactly why they crucified him. In Revelation chapter 1, verse 11, saying, I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last. And so we see that Jesus was saying everything that Jehovah in the Old Testament was saying, and the command was that there's only one God. You're only going to see one God. God is going to wrap his, God is a spirit, and he's going to wrap himself in the flesh. He's going to become the firstborn. Behold, the Lamb of God, which takes away the sins of the world. He's going to become the sacrifice. He's going to become our Savior. In Ephesians, in the New Testament, chapter 4, verse 4, there is one body, And there is one Spirit, even as you're called into one hope. You see, there's so many different people trying to say there's so many different ways to get to God. There's so many different paths to get to God. There's so many different plans of salvation. No, the Bible says there's one body, there's one Spirit, there's only one hope, one called to your hope, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, not different baptisms, one God and Father of all, who is above all and is through all and in you all. So God is omnipresent, and he does not consider it robbery to be omnipresent, be totally everywhere all the time, yet dwell in a vessel and dwell all around the universe and also in you. Exodus chapter 20, verse 1. And God spoke these words, saying, I am the Lord thy God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt and out of the house of bondage, both physically and spiritually. Whether you were in bondage physically or spiritually, he's the one that brought you out. Hallelujah. Thou shalt have no other gods before me. Thou shalt not make thee any graven image or any likeness of anything in heaven or beneath heaven. And you shall not bow thyself to any of them, nor serve them, for I am the Lord thy God, and I am a jealous God. There is no other God. There is only one God. There's only one baptism. There's only one way to be saved. There's only one way that we can ever even imagine to be saved, and that is through Jesus Christ. He is the Lamb. It's his name. It's the power. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Listen, he understands that people know that there is only one God, but what they're not understanding, that he is God. You're not going to pray to God the Father and then Jesus for a while and then the Holy Ghost for a while. No, these three are one. John chapter 10, verse 30 says, I and my Father are one. If you have seen me, you have seen the one that sent me. If you have sent me, you have seen the one that has created and called me to be your Savior. He said, Philip, and to the rest of the disciples, whom do men say that I am? And some say, well, you're Elijah. Some you say you're a prophet. Some you say this, or some say that. And he says, but who do you say that I am? And he says, you are what? You are the Christ. You are the anointed one. Hallelujah. And he said, it's not flesh and blood that has revealed this. It's the what? It's the Spirit that has revealed this. The Bible tells us that we must worship him in truth and in spirit. We must worship him in spirit and in truth. The Father seeks such to worship him. We must have truth, and we must have his Spirit. Now let me share some other scriptures here with you tonight. Amen. We're going to see here that Psalms 86:10, for thou art great and doest wondrous things. Thou art God, and you are God all alone. There is no other God. There is only one God. The Bible never talks anything about a Trinity. It's not in the Bible. It's a man-made word that has been made up. 300 AD, when the Catholic Church started, they came up with the Trinity, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And they began to repeat the command instead of obey the command. We baptize you in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. Why didn't they use the name? Because they thought they would leave somebody out. Isaiah chapter 44, verse 8. Fear ye not, neither be afraid. Have not I told thee from that time, and have declared it? Ye even are my witnesses. And there is God, and there is no God beside me. Yea, there is no God. I know not any. So God's telling us quite clearly, there is no other God. There is no other God. If you would, turn to Isaiah 45, verse 18. And in this scripture, he says, For thus saith the Lord that created the heavens. Who's the creator? God is the creator. He was in the beginning. He is in the ending. He is the only God. He's the only one that created all things. God himself that formed the earth and made it. He hath established it. He has created it. Not in vain. He formed it to be something that is to be inhabited. And it says, I am the Lord, and there is none else beside me. How many of you know there's only one God? If you will look quickly to 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 5, the scripture says, for there is one God. This is New Testament. For there is one God and one mediator between God and man, that is the Christ Jesus. So he is there, and he is there to be the mediator. And we understand that Jesus is Jehovah wrapped in the flesh. Now look at Mark chapter 12, verse 29. And Jesus answered him. They're trying to trip Jesus up here. The first of all commandments is, hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. One Lord. What they were doing is they came and they tried to trip Jesus up. Jesus, you're saying that you're God. But we're here, we're going to declare to you that there's only one God, because the Old Testament says there's only one God. And so they say, what is the first commandment, Jesus? And Jesus repeated it. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one God. And I could just see him sitting there making that statement, and they're all looking at him going, ha, we got you. And he's going, no, I got you. Hello, there is only one God. I am. In 1 Corinthians chapter 8, 4, as concerning, therefore, the eating of those things that are offered in sacrifice unto idols, we know that an idol is nothing in the world, and that there is none other God but one. Hallelujah. So there is only one God. Time and time again, scripture after scripture, we see that there is only one God. Isaiah 45, 21 and 22. Tell ye and bring them near, yea, let them take counsel together, who hath declared this from the ancient time, who hath told it from that time. Have not I the Lord, and there is no God else beside me, a just God and a Savior? There is none beside me. Look unto me and be ye saved, all the ends of the earth, for I am God and there is none else. I am the only God. There is no other. I'm not going to change my mind and create some son who's going to go ahead and take the sacrifice and become the sacrifice. And we're going to, you know, I'm going to make three gods instead of one. He never ever said that there was. He says, no, in the beginning, there was no God before me. There's not going to be one after me. My word never changes. I never change. There is none else, and there will never be any else. So you either got to get revelation that Jesus was God, or you crucify him like they did. Now, one way that I like to explain it to some people, if I write you a check for $10,000, I write your name and I'm writing the check out for $10,000, and at the bottom, if I put, I'm a husband. Hallelujah. I'm a father. I'm a son. I'm a pastor. I can have all kinds of titles, but if I don't sign the check in my name, guess who's not cashing the check? Nobody. It's got to be in my name. So if I command you to do something in my name, it's okay. Hallelujah. That's all right. If I command you to do something in my name, you don't use my title husband, father, son, pastor. You're going to use my name. Say amen, somebody. Amen. That's okay. I'm all right. We're almost done. Praise God. So they're worried about me sweating, but I'm okay. I'll survive. Hallelujah. Amen. And so we have to understand that we need to know who God is. We need the revelation of who God is. We need to know that there's only one God. He said that he came down from heaven. He wrapped himself in the flesh. He became a man. He became a servant. He did not consider it robbery or unequal to be God, the Spirit omnipresent through the whole universe, yet be a man who humbles himself even to the death of the cross. Hallelujah. And that someday every knee shall what? Shall bow and say that Jesus Christ is Lord of all. There is only one God. The devils even know and tremble. They know he's the Holy One. Time after time after time. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God. The Word was with God. The Word was God. And in John chapter 1, verse 14, and that Word became flesh. How did that Word, which is God, become flesh? He came as the baby in the manger, that Christ Jesus, Jehovah, who became our salvation, Jesus, Emmanuel, it means God's going to be with us. How can God be with us? He's going to come off his throne. He's going to wrap himself in the flesh. He's going to be the anointed Christ. He's going to be the Savior of the world. He's not going to sacrifice anything. Animals in blood anymore. He's going to sacrifice his own blood, and he's going to become what? The Savior of the world. The blood is going to cover our sins for those that call on his name. What's his name? Jesus. Repent of your sins and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins, and ye shall receive his Spirit, the Spirit of God, the Holy Ghost. Say amen. Amen. So one more scripture we want to look at tonight. We want to look real quick at, I believe it's 2 Timothy 3:16. And I love this scripture. It explains a lot. And without controversy, of course it's not always easy to understand the scriptures. Some people wrestle with the scriptures to their own destruction. Hallelujah. And without controversy, great is the mystery of godliness. God was manifest in the flesh. God was manifest in the flesh. Who? God was manifest in the flesh. In the beginning was the Word was with God, the Word was God, and the Word was made flesh. Hallelujah. He was justified in the Spirit. He was seen of angels. Tell me, who was the flesh of God? Who was seen of angels? Who preached to the Gentiles? Who was believed in the world? And who was received up into glory? The answer, of course, is Jesus. Jesus is God manifest in the flesh. God manifest in the flesh, justified in the Spirit, glory to God. He was seen of angels. He preached to the Gentiles. He was received up into glory. We understand Jesus is God. God is Jesus. He is the rock. In the Old Testament, God was the rock. Jesus comes and said, he's the rock. In the Old Testament, God said he was our salvation. Jesus comes and said, I am your salvation. Jesus, hallelujah, glory to God. He says, in the Old Testament, God, Jehovah, is the shepherd. In the New Testament, Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. Hallelujah. Hey, he's either lying and he's a false prophet, or he is the revelation that God is a spirit. He came and made himself flesh, and he dwelt among us. He preached to the Gentiles. He was received up into glory. Hallelujah. Justified by the Spirit and seen of angels. Glory to God. And Colossians 2:9 says, for in him dwelleth all the fullness of the Godhead bodily. Are you hearing me tonight? John chapter 1, 18, no man hath seen God at any time. The only begotten Son, which is in the bosom of the Father, he hath declared him. Can somebody say amen? John chapter 12, 45, and he that seeth me seeth him that sent me. Titus 2, 13, looking for the blessed hope and the glorious appearing of the great God and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Colossians chapter 1, verse 15, who is the image of the invisible God, who is the image of the invisible God, who is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of every creature. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Why don't you lift up your hands right now if you don't know, hallelujah, that Jesus is God wrapped in the flesh. Right now, why don't you just begin to praise him? Why don't you begin to call on that name which is above every name. Jesus, Jehovah, our Halama Koshata, who became our salvation. Jehovah, the Spirit of God, who came and wrapped himself in the flesh, born of a virgin. Hikorobosaya, God came to be with us. Hikoromoshata ilabakaya, ilomohaya. If you believe that there's one God, you do well. Halama sikoroboshataya, even the devils know and tremble. Haha, kikoromohaya, ilomohaya. Glory to your name. Ilama kondia raba sandia raba koshataya. Ilama sandia labahaya. He is the Alpha. He is the Omega. He is the beginning. He is the ending. He is the first. He is the last. He is the creator of all things. He is our rock. He is our shepherd. He is our salvation. Halamakai. Ilama hoshata. I looked up and I saw one that sat upon the throne. I did not see three. I only saw one throne, and I saw one setting upon that throne. Halamakaye, ikoroboshandayaha, ilamasikoroboshaya. In Jesus' name. Praise God. If you're watching tonight or you're watching in the future, if you have not been baptized in Jesus' name, maybe you have been baptized in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Maybe you were baptized with someone repeating the command instead of obeying the command. You'll see in the book of Acts, the action of the apostles, every time that they baptize somebody, the reason that we need revelation in the Jesus name and that there's only one God is that when you baptize, you're going to baptize in Jesus' name. Why? Because it's the name of the Father. It's the name of the flesh of God, the Son of God. It is the name of the Holy Spirit or God's Spirit. They are one. If you have seen me, you have seen the Father, said Jesus, because we are one. I do not consider it robbery. I do not consider it unfair to be omnipresent, to yet dwell in the Spirit. And one closing statement I want to share with you. If you take the universe, and let's say we have a fish tank right here, and we fill it up with water. The element is all water, and there's nothing else in the tank but water. And I take an empty bottle, a vessel, and I stick that empty bottle in the vessel, and I take the cap off. That water is going to go inside that vessel, that bottle, and it's going to fill that bottle up. Now, has it changed element at all? No, it's still water. It's just now in the tank, and it's also in the vessel. If I take that bottle out of the tank, the water is still in the vessel, and I put it in the freezer, and I leave it there, and it freezes, it turns to ice, but it's still the same element. If I pour it into a pan, and I turn the stove on, and it turns into steam, it's still the same element. God can manifest himself in different ways, but he's still God. God can be omnipresent. God can be in Japan, Pakistan, Guyana, South America. He can be across the United States. He can be omnipresent, but he can also be here, and he can be in you. He can feel his Spirit into your vessel, and you can become a temple of the Holy Ghost. And God does not change. He's still God. So God's Spirit, omnipresent, came and He chose to dwell in this particular anointed vessel, Jesus Christ. But His Spirit never changed. He was still God living through the vessel, the flesh of God. And when we get to heaven and we look up at the throne, we're only going to see one. You're only going to see the flesh of God, Jesus Christ, the Messiah, the Savior, the only God who sets up on the throne. Praise God. Please join us next Wednesday about the same time. We're going to be continuing our Bible study, part two of this lesson, with our friends in Turks and Caicos through Zoom, but we'll also be on our YouTube and our FaceTime or Facebook Live. And so please join us at the same time next week. We may go a few minutes longer next week, but stay in there with us. We still won't go another 15 or 20 minutes, so we'll still close by 8 o'clock. So God bless you. Thank you for tuning in, and we will see you Sunday morning at 10:15. God bless you. Have a great night. In Jesus' name.